I can't tell you.
Hello, Dino.
He's a tech savvy guy, gonna show you the way. You better load your bags, cause crypto's here to stay. Listen up, gonna teach you about this and
about half an hour ago, and this is their first influencer video to talk about Electronium. So this is out on their site, their Facebook page, which has got about 2 million followers. So we're expecting quite a lot of traffic driven from this in the next couple of days.
So this is a real NMO that's going to actually promote Electronium this time and get us right out there. And there it is, guys.
CellCard, who are the biggest Khmer-owned mobile company, direct mobile company. So they're an MNO in Cambodia. They have about 6 million customers. And we've let them take the lead on pushing out on the marketing content, but also
that's exciting to see.
Since this is on Crypto Daily, so this went up about a few minutes ago, which is an article as well about going live in Cambodia. So this runs through talking about what we're doing with them. There's a lot more to follow, but this is just an initial article that came out this morning. There's some more to come.
That's spectacular. And they'll be able to obviously promote, get the M1s out for people to use.
Yep.
And
so,
I'd imagine there'd be off-ramps also where they could spend it someplace.
Yep, so in here, if I just show you a couple of things. So this is just some pictures that were taken yesterday in one of the stores in Phnom Penh in Cambodia. So they have five stores at the moment which have the M1s being sold in their store. So they're doing that on quite low key basis at the moment, and then towards the end of the month they're going to be running a promotion on the M1.
It's spectacular.
Yep. So this is this first quarter is huge for us in terms of any task going into beta, which I guess you guys have heard all about, going live with CellCard. So those are the two huge things certainly that are going to expand and take a lot of our time in quarter one, along with we've done an update to our blockchain yesterday as well with some functionality which will support some of the stuff we're doing later in the year. So and then when we move into quarter two, we'll then be looking a little bit more around task score and some other products. But so the quarter one is really heavily focused around CellCard and AnyTask. So AnyTask is now out there to about 6,000 people, but it's gone exponentially beyond that. So it's going out to a further 20,000 people in the next week, and then at the end of February we'll start looking at a judgment call on when we then make that an official live launch. But it's way exceeded our expectations just in the first week.
So let me get him out the door. I'm on his phone.
So exciting things.
CellCard are in Cambodia. Are they in any other countries?
CellCard are just in Cambodia. Well, I say that. No, that's not strictly true. They're in Laos. They're in a little bit in Thailand and a little bit in places like Myanmar. So they've got some smaller regional kind of outfits. The majority of the core of their business is in Cambodia itself. And so obviously we're pushing at the moment, or in the next month, well, certainly the next 3 months of our trial period with them, but also we're going to then be driving that into AnyTask as well, so to become intertwined. Because then you have a way in which not only are people earning ETM rewards, earning ETM rewards and only being able to spend it on airtime and data, but then they're also able to have an outlet to then earn in AnyTask to earn more ETM. So by intertwining those, you kind of complete that ecosystem of being able to earn more ETM. And we're also looking at routes within the next quarter to be able to spend ETN within, let's say, commercial outlets, so that you can actually use that to buy food, drink, possibly pay bills.
So they're thinking in the next month, you say?
In the next quarter, I would say.
Next quarter. Yeah. They'll start having the ability to start spending it.
We hope so, yes. We're working hard on that at the moment. So Nigel, one of our guys, is in Selkirk at the moment. So it's about 7 p.m. there, so he's probably just clocked off after a hard week to go for a beer.
So all this quiet, you know, everybody's like, oh, ETN's so quiet. Obviously, you guys have been working your tush off.
Well, to be perfectly honest, we learned some important lessons, and that was that we were we were struggling through overcommitment and under delivery. So we've completely switched that around now, so we'll do a lot less talking and a lot more delivering. And we figure that's the best way to do things, because the proof points are out there. Once we put stuff out, it's real, it's there, it's tangible, people can actually look, see, feel it. Whereas before, we were, these things take a long, long time to come to fruition. So when we're speaking about these things, sometimes you'd get halfway through a project and realise that, well, actually, we need some additional functionality. So we pushed that out because we really wanted the product to be its best when it comes out. And I think any task is a prime example of what a great job that's been. It's taken us longer than we wanted, but it's a much better product than we envisaged coming to market in its minimal viable product form. So these things take time, but we'll, as you can see, we're all working hard here to make it happen. There's a buzz around the place. And it's getting there. And a lot of last year's work certainly is culminating in this first quarter and kind of manifesting itself out into the marketplace.
Perfect. All right, I'm going to take a look around. And
please do.
And good night.
Captain Kangaroo.